Namaste, welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we'll see a very healthy recipe made from this Godhava Rava, Wheat Rava, broken wheat. It's a medium size one, not the very large one. So for this, I have taken one small cup of this. Whichever cup you take to measure, it doesn't matter. Everything you measure with the same cup. So one cup of Wheat Rava we have to take. And first we have to heat a tablespoon of oil, add some mustard seeds and urad dal, next add in this wheat rava to it and also stir fry it for a couple of minutes till the rava is well roasted and you get a good aroma. Keep stirring it continuously till you get a slightly reddish color and a good aroma also. Now you can switch it off. Be sure to stir it, otherwise it might get burnt. Now allow this to cool down to room temperature. See, now this has come down to room temperature. To this we have to add sour curds. See, this is 1 cup of sour curds added to it and another 1/2 cup. Totally 1.5 cups of sour curd. Everything you are measuring with the same cup. Whichever you use to measure, use the same measure and mix it well. We have not yet added salt to this. Add the required quantity of salt. Add a few finely chopped coriander leaves. Mix it and just allow it to stand for 10 minutes. I have kept some water for steaming the idlis. Now let us have a look at this. See, it has absorbed all the curd. Now you can add a little more water to this to get the right consistency. First add 1/2 cup of water and mix it well. Little more water just so that we get the desired consistency. So totally first 1/2 cup and then maybe another 1/4 cup, totally 3/4 cup of water I have used. Now keep an idli stand ready. I have greased the plates with some oil. If you have some grated carrot you can use. Today I'm going to use this frozen piece. This is optional, just for to make it look good also. And here, this Eno fruit salt, I've used it in many of my recipes. Just before keeping it for steaming, you add about 1/4 teaspoon of this and give it a good mix. Now you can pour out this idli batter into the molds. Is boiling well. Keep the idlis for steaming for about 8 minutes. It will be done. We steamed the idlis for 10 minutes and switched it off. Just allow it to cool a little bit and now we remove the idlis. make a tasty side dish for this. We'll make a pudina kara chutney. For that, you take about half a tablespoon of oil in a pan and add 1 tablespoon of channa dal to it and 2 dry red chillies. Fry them till the dals turn a nice reddish brown color. Next, this is 1 onion which I have chopped roughly and also 1 tomato. So, again fry them all together for a couple of minutes. Add some salt. See, the tomatoes have become soft and the onions are also nearly done. At this stage, I have a small bowl of pudina or mint leaves. You can just wash it and add it to it. And again, fry them all together for another few minutes. Now you can switch it off. And when it comes to room temperature, we'll grind it to a paste in our blender jar. Our chutney is now ground and ready. You can serve it with these idlis. It's a very tasty accompaniment. And let me show you how the idlis are absolutely soft and fluffy. They are so easy to make, good on taste, and doesn't consume much time because there is no fermentation, no grinding. I'm sure you will get hooked on to the taste of these. Wheat rava, lapsi, godam rava, broken wheat, cream of wheat, cracked wheat, different names. But this is basically broken wheat idli. So try out this recipe, share it with your family and friends. And do come back to Geeta's Kitchen for more such easy, tasty, healthy, and this is a diabetic friendly recipe. Thank you.